Good morning, Davao, Mindanao, North, South, East, and West. My name is Elijah Hill Cacho, your newscaster for today. But before we get started, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to this channel for more content like this. For the headlines, weather forecast. Easterlies affecting the eastern section of Visayas and Mindanao. Local news. Successful Davao Coastal Road Cleanup Day. Davao Oriental celebrates the second year of insurgency for free. Nabunturan residents warned versus BIR employee imposters. Martial law commemoration is peaceful. National news. DepEd starts procurement processes for 2025. Top of the week. Issues of left to hang this weekend in Cebu City included the pool slates and old quarrels. International news. Weakened and infiltrated, Hezbollah vows says battle without limits against Israel. A hunting final message and other takeaways from the Coast Guard inquiry into the Titan submersible implosion. Entertainment news. Tia Mowry says she and her sister Tamira aren't close anymore. Here's a 9 other famous duos who prove relationships are hard. Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson meets students from the Appalachian High School during visit into the Atlanta set. Sports news. Lando Norris eases to Singapore Grand Prix victory to reduce Max Verstappen's lead into the Drivers' Championship. 2024 NFL Week 3. The best of the Sunday's games and the standout storylines. Featured stories. Positively, the best pet shop in the Philippines. Fantastic finds await in Michigan. Trivia. Did you know that the most popular phone in the Philippines is Realme? Weather forecast. Easterlies affecting the eastern section of Visayas and Mindanao. Bicol region, eastern Visayas, Caraga, and Davao region. Partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms due to easterlies. Flash floods or landslides may occur during severe thunderstorms. Metro Manila and the rest of the country, partly cloudy to cloudy skies without isolated rain showers or thunderstorms caused by the localized thunderstorms. Flash floods or landslides may occur during the severe thunderstorms. Local news, successful Davao Coastal Cleanup Day. The Department of Environment and Natural Resources, also known as DENR, in Davao region reports the ocean litter collected during International Coastal Cleanup Day will drive efforts to reduce marine pollution. Regional Director Ma Mercedes Dumagan stressed that the initiative isn't just about removing trash, but understanding its sources to create long-term solutions. This year's theme, Clean Seas for a Blue Economy, highlighted the importance of sustainable action. Over 7,651 volunteers across Davao City collected around 3,060 sacks of waste, with Davao City alone gathering 7,435 kilograms of debris the Philippines celebrate Coastal Cleanup Day every third Saturday of September. Davao Oriental celebrates the second year of Insurgents Free. Davao Oriental celebrates its second year of being Insurgents Free on September 19, 2024, emphasizing the vital role of youth in sustaining peace. The event at the provincial capital gathered 1,800 students, partnered agencies, and former rebels. Governor Ninyo Uy praised the province's sustainable programs in healthcare, livelihood, and agriculture, affirming that they aim to create long-term solutions. Uy also honored the contributions past administration and the collective collaborative efforts that led to peace. A check for 300,000 pesos was presented to a local organizations while former rebels showcased livelihood products. They ended with the ceremonial pigeon release. Nabunturan residents warned versus BIR employee imposters. Nabunturan's local government urges a resident to verify the identity of everyone claiming to be Bureau of Internal Revenue, so known as BIR, staff after reports of imposters demanding tax payments. The LGU emphasizes that payments should only be made through official channels, including Revenue Collection Office and authorized agent banks. BIR Tagum clarified that no recent surveys had been conducted in the area, labeling the incidents as scams. Mayor May Rosel Clarine Balili confirmed that neither she nor Government Dorothy Gonzaga authorized any special inspections. Residents are advised to report suspicious activities and to authorities or the LGU's hotline for further actions. Martial law commemoration is peaceful. The Davao City Police Office, or the DCPO, successfully concluded the 52nd commemoration of the Martial Law Rally at Freedom Park on September 21, 2024. With no outward incidents reported, approximately 230 police personnel were assigned for security operations during the event, which drew around 60 participants from various progressive groups, including students, groups such as Bagong Alyansang, Makabayan, and Anak Bayan voiced concerned over long-standing injustices and human rights issues from the Marcos dictatorship and the current administrations. On this day in 1972, former President Marcos Sr. signed Proclamation Number 1081, declaring martial law in the Philippines. National news. DepEd to start procurement processes for 2025. Department of Education Secretary Sonny Angara has announced an initiative to expedite procurement for goods and services for 2025. In a statement on September 23, Angara signed DepEd Memorandum 049 Series of 2024, which mandates early procurement activities, or EPA, to award contracts prior to the fiscal year. This initiative spans all levels of DepEd governance and encompasses various procurement stages, focusing on high priority projects such as textbooks, e-learning packages, and school infrastructures. The bidding process begins in October 2024, with contracts expected to be awarded by January 2025. Top of the week, issues left to hang this weekend in Cebu included the pool slates, old quarrels. Number one, Cebu City Acting Mayor Raymond Alvin Garcia and MCWD Chief Joey Daluz sparked speculations about a potential tandem for 2025 elections after attending a concert political activity together. However, they clarified they were simply old friends attending the same event, with no concrete plans revealed. Number 2. Tomas Osmeña's recent allegation in Congress against Michelle Dino could potentially shift dynamics for 2025 race. His testimony might strengthen anti-Osmeña forces and prompt investigations and into Dino, impacting the electoral landscape. Osmeña is expected to disclose information about Cebu killings linked to extrajudicial actions during the Duterte war on drugs, although he may avoid revealing damaging details. Number 4. Gwen Garcia's lawyers indicate there's no immediate legal risk following the Supreme Court ruling requiring her to pay $700,000 to HSBC, suggesting enforcement of this debt is not imminent. This statement aims to reassure the public about her legal standing post-ruling. International news. Weakened and infiltrated. Hezbollah vows battle without limits against Israel. An Israeli airstrike obliterated a 9-story apartment building in Beirut's southern suburb, resulting in at least 45 deaths, including 16 Hezbollah militants and civilians. The attack, targeting a meeting of the elite Radwan force, left scenes of devastations. Dust covered rescuers struggling with lifeless bodies and corpses hastily transported on quad bikes. Tensions mounted as plainclothes Hezbollah members seized phone from onlookers, demanding the deletion of photos. Just days prior, detonations of walkie-talkies and pagers linked to Hezbollah resulted in further casualties, with over 80 killed since the recent escalation, primarily among the group's operatives, but also affecting innocent bystanders. A haunting final message and other takeaways from the Coast Guard inquiry into the Titan submersible implosion. More than a year after the Titan submersible's tragic implosion, which claimed the lives of all 5 aboard, hearing by a U.S. Coast Guard panel have unveiled a narrative of hubris and greed. Testimonies have revealed a troubling portrayal of OceanGate, the company behind the 23,000-pound submersible, and its founder, who charged passengers for $250,000 per dive. Harvard oceanographer Peter Gierges highlighted the tragic irony of the Titan's failure occurring near the Titanic wreck, another symbol of the pride and disaster. Witnesses reported a troubling company culture focused on profit, a malfunction shortly before the implosion, and ignored warning leading to the catastrophe. Entertainment news. Tia Mowry says she and her sister Tamira aren't close anymore. Here are the 9 other famous duos who prove relationships are hard. Twin sister Tia Mowry and Tamira Mowry, Hosley, stars of Sister Sister, are facing a changing dynamic, with Tia expressing a desire for closer contact after her divorce. This theme of drifting apart is seen on other notable duos. Keegan Mitchell Key and Jordan Peele, once inseparable, now see each other infrequently. Paris Hilton and Nicole Rich are reuniting for a new show despite past feuds. Liam and Noel Gallagher of Oasis have announced a reunion tour, signaling a recollection, and many other more. Dwayne Johnson meets the student from the Appalachian High School during visits to Atlanta set. Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson recently visited students at the Appalachian High School in Winder, Georgia, following a tragic shooting that left 4 dead and 9 injured. Sharing photos and videos on Instagram, Johnson emphasized the healing power of joy and laughter. He met with the members of the school's football team, expressing admiration for their resilience despite their pain. The shooter, 14-year-old Colt Gray, faces 4 counts of felony murder and will be tried as an adult. His father, Colin Gray, is charged with multiple counts related to the incident. Johnson plans to support the team further by attending their first home game. Sports news. Lando Norris eases to Singapore Grand Prix victory to reduce Max Verstappen's lead in Drivers' Championship. British driver Lando Norris secured a decisive victory at the Singapore Grand Prix, narrowing Max Verstappen's lead in the Drivers' World Championship to 52 points. This win marks Norris' third of the season and follows teammate Oscar Piastri's recent victory in Azerbaijan. With Piastri finishing third in Singapore, the successful outing also boosted McLaren's position in the Constructors' Championships, extending their lead over Red Bull. Together, Norris and Piastri earned a total of 40 points, giving McLaren a 41-point advantage over Red Bull. The team's strong performance fueled hope and of clinching their first championship since 1998. 2024 NFL Week 3, the best of Sunday's games and the standout storylines. Week 3 of the 2024 NFL season presents a pivotal moment for teams, offering chances for redemption or to maintain momentum. As the season progresses, franchise fortunes are beginning to unfold. The Carolina Panthers, after a winless start, have benched last year's number one overall draft pick, Bryce Young, due to struggles on the first 2 weeks of the game. This move reflects the urgency among teams to make changes, with others also prepared to take drastic actions if results don't improve this week's game. The stakes are high as teams seek to turn their season around early. Featured stories. Positively, the best pet shop in the Philippines. In the Philippines, Pets Manila stands out as the premier destination for pet lovers. Located in the Quezon City, it offers a wide variety of pets, supplies, and services. Their acknowledgeable staff ensures customers find the perfect furry companion while providing grooming and training services. Another top spot is Pet Express, known for its extensive selection of pet foods and accessories. Across multiple branches nationwide, both places prioritize pet welfare and offers a welcoming atmosphere for all animal enthusiasts. Fantastic finds await in Michigan. In Michigan, Woofers and Warriors in Livonia is the most visit for pet owners. This unique shop not only sells pets and supplies but also partners with local shelters to promote adoption. Their selection of premium pet products and commitment to animal welfare to make it a favorite among locals. Another gem is Pitco. With various locations throughout Michigan, providing everything from pet food to grooming services. Both places emphasize a healthy lifestyle of pets and excellent customer service, making them ideal for all pet enthusiasts. Trivia. Did you know that the most popular phone in the Philippines is Realme? The smartphone market in the Philippines is dominated by Realme, particularly the Realme C series, which resonates with budget-conscious customers. Known for its impressive specifications and affordability, the Realme C25Y has become the favorite, offering features like a 50-megapixel camera and a large battery at a competitive price. Xiaomi and Samsung also hold significant market shares with models like a Redmi Note series and Galaxy A series, appealing to different users' demographics. Overall, the local demand for high-quality and yet affordable smartphones continue to shape the market landscapes, making Realme a standout choice for many Filipinos. That is all for our news today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to this channel for more content like this. Good morning, Davao!